Hi, in this video I will make a homemade leg vise, and I will use some pieces of wood I could find in my shop, plus a big metallic clamp. And the best part is that if we need to use the big metallic clamp, we can remove it from the leg vise. And we can keep using it. I will install the leg vise here. So I mark the piece I need to make the vise jaw. But right here I have a couple of knots, so I move the mark to avoid those knots. And I cut the piece I need. I also cut a bevel in the top part of the vise jaw. This will be the back of this wooden jaw. And this big metallic clamp will be the screw I will use to tighten the leg vise. Then this clamp will press more or less around here. But first I have to remove the fixed jaw of this clamp. Now I want the fixed jaw to slide all along the metallic bar. And it must slide when it is at a very small angle with the metallic bar, but it must get blocked when something presses here and the jaw moves to a 90 degrees angle, so I can modify the hole until it has a very small inclination. Here I paint it very exaggerated. The important part is that I must not modify this point so it can grab the metallic bar. The same with this point, but here I can open the hole up. Nothing here. And here I can open the hole down. But well, I just need a very slight inclination. Just enough so the jaw slides easily, but even so it can get blocked. Anyway, most of the work is to file the sides of the hole so the metallic bar can enter. I also file the end of the metallic bar, because it has some deformation there to block the jaw. And after some minutes working with the file, now the bar enters and it slides easily, but even so I can block it when needed. Now the clamp will press here, so I have to measure this. And this is the center of the wooden jaw. I mark the measurement on the line. I center the screw on the mark. And I draw the shape of the hole, because here I must make a through mortise to insert the metallic bar. Well, I will make a mortise some bigger than the bar, so it enters easily. I clean the mortise. And now the metallic bar enters easily. Then the leg vise goes here. I put it flush with the side of the workbench. And I mark the width of the leg in the wooden jaw. We'll see later what are these marks for. Now I put the leg vise jaw in its position in the workbench. And I mark the hole position in the leg in the workbench. Well, to make sure the hole will be in the right position, I also measured. And well, you can see it is not in the center of the leg. But it is not very near the side of the leg neither. So now I can drill the through mortise. Then the metallic bar enters here very loose. And the fixed jaw goes here. And if I put the fixed jaw against the workbench leg, it still slides. But if I press the metallic bar down, it blocks. I nail some small plywood strips around the fixed jaw. And now I have a place to put the fixed jaw when I need to install the leg vise. Before I continue, I have to file the heads of these screws, because they protrude the apron surface. And here, flush with the apron surface, I put a wooden block. Now this is the back of the leg vise. I turn it and I will glue these hardwood pieces on the front. I apply a very thin layer of glue. Like this, they won't slide too much, so they will be easier to set in place. And now I wait until the glue dries. Now I have two small planks like this one. I put them here against the marks I made in the bottom part of the wooden jaw. I mark the height of the planks. And I will cut following these lines to remove this and this. Now this is the front of the leg vise. One small plank goes here. I mark the thick of the wooden jaw in the back of the plank and I drill a couple of guide holes. And I do the same with the other small plank. I use some double-sided tape to stick one plank on the other. And I have already made some marks to drill this pinboard parallel guide. I sand everything and now I can screw the pinboard parallel guide. I have to make sure they are both in the right position so the holes are aligned and I can insert the pin to block the pinboard parallel guide. Now I drill here a guide hole. and I insert a Cornish hook. Like this, the Cornish hook will help to keep the fixed jaw in place. Finally, I can install this leg vise in the workbench. And let's see how it works. I will clamp this piece. I insert the wooden pin in the holes, so the wooden clamp will be parallel to the workbench leg, and now I can clamp it with this homemade leg vise, and I check how hard it clamps. A good thing is that I have a lot of room over the metallic bar, so I can put here very wide planks and boards. Anyway, in another video, I'll try to improve this leg vise a little bit. Thanks for watching. If you think this is an interesting video, don't forget to click like and share. And if you like my videos, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and to click the bell to get the notifications.